Hi guys, how are you? I hope all you are doing good. Welcome to the Learn Code Easily. So today we will do one more question, or today we will do one question, and that is reduced array size to the half, and it is a least code July. Yeah, so it is lead code July challenge, and in this we are solving this problem. So I have just solved, and it is a medium level question, but it is not so hard because I have completed this question within 2 or 3 minutes. So I will tell you that how I solved. I will first tell you the approach, then I will implement here already. Although I have implement, but for you I will implement again. So let's begin with our new question, and it is a very easy question. It's a medium level, but it is very easy. The question is, given an array, you can choose a set of integer and remove all the occurrence of these integers in the array. Return the minimum size of the set so that at least half of the integer of the array are removed. You have to choose that element if you remove all occurrence of that element so that the size become half. Example, if you take the size of this array is 10, if you take 3, then you can remove only 4 element, and this is the maximum element which has a occurrence of maximum, because 3 is existing more than 2 time, because 5 is existing 2 is existing 2 time, so more than 2, 5 is existing 3 time, and 3 is existing more than 5 time, so the maximum element we could remove at the first time 4. So if you remove 4, then the total length is 10, and if you remove 3, so the length becomes 6, but it is not less than or equals to the half of the array, so you have to remove some other element. So you after this you choose the maximum occurrence of element. So 5 is the element which is occurring more than 2 time, because 2 is occurring 2 times, so you have to find which is occurring more than all the element except the highest element. So this is the element which is occurring more than every element. So first you will choose 3, then you will choose 5, so this will become complete 7, and 10 minus 7 is 3, and the half of this is 5, so 3 is less than 5. Yes, in this at least half. So if you choose 3, if you choose 5 and 2, this is also possible, because if you remove this, then it become also 10 minus 5 is 5, and 5 less than equals to 5. Yes, if you will choose 3 and 2, this is also possible, because why? Because this will become 6, and 10 minus 6 is 4, and this is less than the half of this, but you cannot choose 2 or 7, because why? Because 10 minus 3 is 7, and 10 divided by 2 is equal to 5, so 7 is less than 5, no, so you cannot choose. In this, if you choose 7, you can remove all the element, and after removing it will become empty. So 0 is less than the length of this by 2, because you have to divide it, you have to divide so that the length of the array at least be half, so this is also possible. You can remove 1, you can remove 9 as well, so the length will become 1. In this, if you remove 1000, so the length become 2, and it is equal to the half. Yes, if you remove 3, then it is not possible. If you remove 3 7, then it is possible, but you have to remove the minimum element. So the minimum element is 1000. You have to choose a one element and remove all the occurrences. So in this there is no duplicate, so you have to remove 5 of the element. You can remove any of the element, this, or you can maybe you can remove this, and this is also possible. So what I have done here, the simplest approach, let's take the length of array is equals to length of array. So what we will do, for storing the occurrence of every element, we need a dictionary. I know that the dictionary is the best data structure which you can use to store the occurrence of every element. So let's traverse our array for I in AR of, so D of I, if I in D, if it is present in D, then means it is already present. Just increase count frequency by 1. Otherwise, if it is not, then initialize that with 1. So frequency of element is this. So this is the we are storing this the frequency of element. So this has been done. Now what I have to do, I have to choose an element that has a maximum occurrence. So for that we have to sort in which manner, from increasing to decreasing. So let's sort our D dictionary. So we are sorting to D is equals to lambda of D of X, and it will sort increasing smallest to bigger, but we have to sort from biggest to smallest. That's why reverse is equals to true. By writing this, it will reverse our complete array. Means if we have 1, 2, 3, if we write this reverse is equals to true, then it will become 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so we have sorted. Now we have the maximum. So we are just traversing this list one. And what we will do, we are just taking an element and fetching the frequency of that element and checking if the length of the array minus someone, it is less than or equals to length of array by 2, or you can say length of array by 2, because I have stored that that length in an array. If it is, then you have to return count. So what is count? Count is, we have to increase count by 1, or in this we have to initialize sum and count by 0, 0. So if it is for, then it is also okay. So it is done. Now it will check every time. So that's it, I think. This is the fastest, this is the most efficient solution. You can see that it is 64. Okay, so this is your my implementation. So I will tell you that I want to tell you one more thing, that how it actually work. Maybe some of you haven't understand what I have done here. So in this I have stored the frequency. So when I will sort, so it will store the frequency, it will store the element, like if I have this thing. So what it will do, so after sorting, so we are sorting on the basis of frequency, because frequency of element is it is the frequency, because frequency of element of any element, it is incremented by 1, that means it is stored the frequency. So this is the frequency. So I will have 4, 2, 1. So this is, I have, like if I take 1, 1, 1. So in this I will have this in the list one, because I am sorting on the basis of frequency. So this is the 4, that's why it come first. Then this is the 4, that's why it will come 1. And this is the less frequency, because this is occurring 2 times, that's why it is at the, if I have 6 4 3 3 3. So it will come 3, 1 because the 3 have the 3 frequency and 2 have the 2 frequency. So that so here we are just traversing. We are going there. We are taking the frequency of element of 4. So 4 is occurring 4 times. So it will do some 1 plus. So it will become 4. It will become 4. Now incremented count by 1. Why? Because I have traversed one of the element. Okay. So length of array is like assume that it is a 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Okay. So it has been. So it is 13. So 14. 14 minus 4 is 10. 10 is less than 7. No. So it will again go and it will again store the frequency. So the next element is 1. So 1 is occurring 4 times. So previously it was stored 4, now it will again store 4. So the total become 8. So 14 minus 8 is 6. So 6 is less than 7. Yes. So it will return 2. Because why? Because 4 and 1 we have to need only traverse 2 of the element. Because why? Because this is the element that is occurring maximum time. So that's it. I hope you have understood. So bye bye guys. I will again meet you in the next video. So please subscribe this channel, likes and comment and share this playlist so that I could get good get motivation and I should make something good. I am doing my hard work, so I believe that you should give at least one like and comment. So bye bye guys, and a humble request to all who are seeing this video, please share and subscribe this channel. Bye bye guys, I will meet in the next video.